Hello and welcome to our online liturgy here at Mosaic Church, where we believe, where we trust, where we want you to know that you matter to God, even if God may not matter to you. And you matter to me, and you matter to us, even if we may not matter to you. Now, I just want to say it's such a blessing to be in this virtual yet still sacred space with you. Let us prepare our hearts and minds to offer our worship to God in our own sacred space.
Bless the Lord, my soul, and bless God's holy name. Bless the Lord, my soul.
Hallelujah! Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, whose Son, Jesus, is the good shepherd of your people, grant that when we hear his voice, we may know him who calls us each by name and follow where he leads, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the works thy hand has made, I see the stars and I hear that rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. Thou art, how great thou art,
Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand, who is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. The hired hand runs away because the hired hand does not care for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own and my own know me, just as the Father knows me and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason, the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have power to lay it down, and have power to take it up again. I have received this command from my Father. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Amen. Now this week I spent a lot of time reading about sheep, and I didn't realize just how relatable sheep are. Like, they are a rather restless and anxious type of animal. And me, myself, I am a rather restless and anxious type of person. I also read that in order for sheep to get rest, there's four conditions that have to be met. They need to be free from fear, free from friction, free from parasites and pests, and free from hunger. Like, how is that not relatable? So when it was time for the sheep to go sleep, to get rest, the shepherd would lure them into the sheep pen that was shaped like a horseshoe, and it didn't have a door. Now, as the sheep was walking in one by one through into the pen, the shepherd would make sure that there's no parasites, that there are no pests upon the sheep. And of course, as they're walking in, they just graze the whole time, so the shepherd knows that these sheep are well fed and they're not hungry. Now, once they're inside the pen, the shepherd makes sure that there's enough space between the sheep so that they're not rubbing up against each other, causing friction. And so now when the shepherd has checked the sheep for parasites and pests, they know that the sheep are well fed, and now that they put enough space in between the sheep, the shepherd will stand in the opening and act as a door, act as a gate to that pen. And the shepherd's presence as a door will give the sheep a sense of security, and now they can rest. See, all the sheep has to do is to focus on that shepherd, on their shepherd, and they know that they will be able to get rest. It's a lesson of faith that we can learn from the sheep, that focusing on the good shepherd can help us get rest from our fears. I think King David knew that. When he wrote the 23rd Psalm, one of the most well-known psalms out there, he starts out with, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want." And then in the middle of that psalm, he writes, "Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death." Now, Leonard Sweet, a pastor and a writer, writes that the only difference between the two significant words in this sentence, "though" and "through," is the letter R. Now, in the American Sign Language, letter R is crossed fingers. And the very, very early Christians made a similar gesture as a way of identifying themselves as Christian, because you can't outright claim that you are a Christian, because that was that was punishable by death. That was a crime. That was, you were claiming that someone else is Lord and not Caesar. So if you wanted to know if someone else was a Christian, was a follower of Christ, you can't ask, "Hey, do you believe in Jesus Christ?" because you don't know if the person that's asking that question is an enemy or it's an ally. You don't know if this is a trap. So oftentimes you would use symbols and gestures and signs to identify one another as a Christian. So if you're curious about this person that you're talking to, if you're wondering if they are a Christian, you might do this. And if they do that in return, you're like, "Oh, let's talk about Jesus." But if you do this and they go, "What are you doing?" You're like, Oh, nothing. My fingers, they have a mind of their own." You know, then you know that you are not in a safe space to talk about Jesus. But along the way, crossing fingers has become associated with good luck. And if you know a Houston Texans fan, you know that their unofficial pose as a fan is this. Maybe this became a symbol of good luck because the early Christians not only used this as a sign of identifying themselves, but they also used this when they were going through trials. When they didn't know how a crisis would turn out, they crossed their fingers as a way of claiming Christ's presence is with them. When they were going through uncertainty, when they were being martyred, when they were literally on trial, a lot of them would stand like this, claiming that Christ is with them, knowing that God has not abandoned them. And other people would see these Christians going, walking through fire while crossing their fingers and displaying a sense of peace. See, when we cross our fingers, when we know that Jesus is with us, we know that Jesus can turn a though into a through. In 2019, when I was going through this transition, I had no idea what was going to happen to me. And it's probably one of the most difficult seasons I've encountered in my profession. But even though I had no idea what might happen to me, I just knew without a single ounce of doubt that I will get through this, that we would get through this, that Christ is with me, that God was with me, and that the end of the tunnel will be near. So you might be experiencing a though. Though I'm being laid off. Though I just received bad news. Though I am sick. Though my child is hurting. Though I'm lost and drifting. Though I'm uncertain. Whatever that your though is, Christ is with me and I will get through. Even though I'm facing a layoff, God is with me. I will get through this. Even though we are still in the midst of a pandemic, God is with us and we will get through this. Even though times are uncertain and I don't know what is going on, God is with me and I will get through this. We have a God that is more powerful than death itself. And in God, we know that the worst thing that can happen to us will not be the last thing. We have Jesus, the Good Shepherd, who was always with us. And He has not forsaken us, and He has not forgotten us. See, what I'm not saying is that everything will return normal. When we are officially done with this pandemic, if that time ever comes, that doesn't mean that we will go back to 2019 and pick off right where we left off. If you're facing a layoff, that doesn't mean that at the end of this tunnel, when you get through it, you'll be at the same job. Things may not end up the way that we wanted to. Things may not end up the way that the way they were before. But we will get through it. Christ will turn that though into a through, and you will be on the other side of this, of whatever you may be going through. What we may need to do is we may need to shift our focus from ourselves and onto Jesus, who says He is the Good Shepherd, who says that He calls us by name, who says that He will lay down His life for us, who has laid down His life for us. Again, I'm not saying that all your problems will disappear magically if you focus on Christ. But what I'm saying is that the peace of Christ is made available to you and that you will be able to get through this. Christ is with you. What could then possibly stand against you? I want to close with the words of King David from the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He lets me rest in grassy meadows. He leads me to restful waters. He keeps me alive. He guides me in proper paths for the sake of His good name. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no danger because You are with me. Your rod and Your staff, they protect me. You set a table for me right in front of my enemies. You bathe my head in oil. My cup is so full, it spills over. Yes, goodness and faithful love will pursue me all the days of my life, and I will live in the Lord's house as long as I live. Peace be with you. And now, will you join me in the affirmation of our faith? We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, He came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, He became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, He rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, He is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray for the church and for the world. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess Your name may be united in Your truth, live together in Your love, and reveal Your glory in the world. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer. Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer. Give us all a reverence for the earth as Your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to Your honor and glory. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer. Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as He loves us. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer. Comfort and heal all who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of Your salvation. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer. We commend to Your mercy all who have died, and that Your will for them may be fulfilled. And we pray that we may share with all Your saints in Your eternal kingdom. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer.
Now let us confess our sins. Merciful God, we have sinned in what we have thought and said, in the wrong we have done, and in the good we have not done. We have sinned in ignorance. We have sinned in weakness. We have sinned through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry. We repent and turn to You. Forgive us for our Savior Christ's sake, and renew our lives to the glory of Your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us all our sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Amen. Peace to the Lord be always with you.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, Your perfect love is casting out fear. Of the storms of this life, I won't turn back. I know You are near, and I will fear no evil. is with me, and if my God is with me, whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear? Oh no, never let go through the coming, through the storm. Coming for the heart that holds on, a glorious life beyond all compare. And there will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, we live to know you're here on this earth, and I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. Shall I fear? Oh no, never let go through the coming, through the storm. Oh no, never let go in every high and every low. Oh no, never let go, Lord, you never let go of me. Yes, I can see the light that is coming. For the heart that holds on, and there will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, still I will praise you, still I will praise you. Yes, I can see the light that is coming for the heart that holds on. There will be an end to these troubles. But until that day comes, still I will praise you, still I will praise you.
It is through your generosity, your sacrificial giving, your sacrificial loving, your commitment to God's vision that continues to push Mosaic into reality so that we may continue to let people know that they matter to God.
Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass to temptation, but deliver us from evil, for thine is the kingdom and the power, the glory forever and ever. Amen. For thine the kingdom and the power, the glory forever and ever.
My dear friends, even though you might be struggling this season, even though you might be in the midst of a difficult time, even though things may not be where you want them to be, God is with you. and so are we. And you will get through this with and by the grace and love of God. Always remember, my dear friends, first we were loved, now we love.
You can hold my hand when you need to let go. I can be your mountain when you're feeling valley low. I can be a street light showing you the way home. If you can hold my hand when you need to let go. I want a house with a crowded table and a place by the fire for everyone. Let us take on the world while we're young and able, and bring us back together when the day is done. If we want a garden, we're gonna have to sow the seeds and plant a little happiness. Let the roots run. If it's love that we give, then it's love that we reap. If we want a garden, we're gonna have to sow the seed. Yeah, I want a house at the crowded table and a place by the fire for everyone. Let us see. On my wall, everyone's a little broken, and everyone belongs. Yeah, everyone belongs. Yeah, I want a house with a crowded table and a place by the fire for everyone. Let us take on the world while we're young. And bring us back together when the day is done. And bring us back together when the day is done. Is done.